going on, everyone? I'm going to take you guys through training vlog number 7. So we are prepping for training. We're about 30 minutes out, which is that pre-workout. Had my banana ready to go. Training session today, we are going to be doing power snatches, full snatches, deficit snatch pulls. We're also going to be doing back squats and hang power clean. So pretty big weightlifting session. Probably going to take 3 to 3.5 hours, including accessories. Looking forward to it. Keen to see what I can do. Training, we're on a new program, so we'll see how we go. Let's get up. Take you guys with me.
What's up, everyone? I'm going to take you through training vlog number 7. So today we built up to some power snatches, full snatches, some deficit snatch pulls, some back squats, and some hang power clean. So quite a long weightlifting session today. I did do a morning session before this in the morning as well. So going to take you guys through this whole session. So regarding my voiceovers and talking like I have been here, I'm going to start doing this in just the lighter sets, like kind of like the technique work with the bar and you know, 50, 70 kilos, etc. And then I'm going to stop and just let the, you know, the video play out and let you guys, you know, hear the feet, hear the positions, look at the technique, the contact, etc. Because obviously, you know, myself as a purist weightlifter, that's what I'd like to be seeing with YouTube videos and stuff. So let me know if you guys are keen on that, but that's what I think I'm going to do. So anyway, starting off the session today of our power snatches, we have got 50 kilos on the bar, feeling really good. Had a rest day the day prior to this, obviously morning session today as well, which was super light, but feeling really snappy Monday night. So I could just tell 50 kilos, things are looking good. So the plan was to build up to 120 today for some triples. That was my program. I also had doubles a bit heavier too, but my coach said just stick to 120 and do some triples. So that's what I did. But yeah, I could tell I was feeling pretty good today with the power snatches. So super happy with that. Here we go, 70 kilos, moving pretty well. Position was feeling good. The thing with power snatches, I sometimes get really excited and I'll use my back a bit too much when I should be using my legs a little bit more. So that's something that I'm trying to work on, keep my chest up. But at the same time, you got to be fast when doing a power snatch. So it's kind of okay to use your back a little bit, but obviously in a full movement, it's a bit different. So we don't want to do that. So here's my second set at 100 for a triple. Gonna stop talking now and just let it play out. Cheers. So pretty happy with the power snatch session up to 120. Things moved really well. I'm really excited to see where I can get my triple power snatches up to end of this block. Won't put any numbers in there, but hopefully we can do something decent. So starting off today with full snatches, I'm at the bar here. Obviously after having a rest day, my hips and my ankles are super tight, so I'm really making sure I'm diligently warming up that bottom positioning, letting myself sit deep, letting my wrists come back, letting my knees come out, pushing through the middle of my foot, and just keep my chest up and just trying to feel comfortable in that position. So lots of sets with the bar, as you can see here, in preparation for the heavier snatch session. Now the plan of the snatches today was to build up to 140, 140 for a couple of singles, triples up to 130, although you'll see in the video I couldn't quite do that. I am on a new phase of my program now, so I've got a new program. Last block, if you guys were following the channel, we were working more on our squats, so getting that up. So we achieved the goals with that program, which was fantastic. Now we're leading more towards building up my power and positions a little bit more. So the program will involve more deficit work, a lot of power emphasis movements, as well as keeping the full movements there. And then once we finish this, you know, 6 or 7 weeks, we'll transition to a competition phase of training where we're really focusing on building up the snatch and clean and jerk. So yeah, again, the goals of this block is to really work on the power. So you'll see this through the up and coming vlogs throughout the next few weeks, is the power is a big emphasis as well as the positions. So anyways, in the full snatches, yeah, my plan was to build up to 130 for some triples, but week one of the program, who knows what to expect. I've written what weights I want to be doing and where I feel I should be, but obviously week one, things are going to be a lot different. Body needs to acclimatize to the program, different stimulus. I'm not starting training with squats, you know, so it's a different type of feeling. So, you know, know, in saying that, after the power snatches, I was actually quite fatigued, especially my traps. So that was something that I haven't actually felt in a while. So something that, you know, I'll get used to, I'm sure, as the weeks progress on this program. So anyways, we are at 100 kilos here. This is my second set. We're just doing triples, really trying to work my second part. That felt really weird, especially after the power snatches. But it is a skill learning how to power snatch heavy and then getting into full snatches straight after. That second part, as well as those traps, do feel fatigued, especially after heavy power. So trying to build that up again. Again, that's the goal of the program. So now we go to 120. Another triple at 100. I did a lot of triples at 100, actually, just get my body working. Anyways, now we are going to go 120. So we built up to 120 here for a triple. Again, the plan was to go to 130 for some triples, but didn't quite feel amazing. So I did just do doubles there. So anyways, I'll let this set play out after, and you guys can watch the snatch sequence. Let's go. Working parties for hours, and I done seen brand fucking bitches from Howard, and I done seen snoops give away an 80 balance. So fuck Jerry Heller and the white superpower. This the shit niggas kill for. They hit a villain, niggas spitting with them nigga flow. Fuck you hoes, fuck you bitch ass niggas too. Got something for your crew. All right, so we now went on to some deficit snatch high pulls. So I did 4x4. I had two sets at 140 and two sets at 150, so they were moving well. Apologies for my coach getting in the way of the singles at 140. He didn't realize the camera was there. I told him shortly after the first set, "Oh, coach, sorry, but the camera's there. I'm just filming for my YouTube video." And he's like, "Oh, sorry, sorry." So he quickly moved out of the way, which was nice. But anyways, you'll see with those 140 snatches, the first set, I actually wanted to I felt like I was going to give it a go to do a double. So after the first rep, you know, so I dropped it down, and then I just realized, you know, I can save this. I'll wait a few weeks. We don't need to be doubling 140 just yet. Singles are fine for now. So yeah, I decided just to leave it there. But yeah, feeling really good though. I'm happy with that. And I think, you know, the coming weeks should be good. Then the second single felt okay. Worked up to 150 with these deficit snatch high pulls. I love doing deficit work. It really helps emphasize that starting position, squeezing that upper back, keeping those shoulder blades together, and really just making you sit deeper and focus on that position. You do use the legs a lot when doing deficit work. So when you do deficit work, you're probably going to be quite fatigued, especially for squats after. And that is exactly what happened. So I'll explain that when we get there. But 150 was moving well. Positions were feeling quite good. Just a different angle here to sort of see how much legs you need to use when doing deficit work. So I haven't done deficit work in a while. So really, really excited to add it back to my training. So we have back squats. Now I didn't post the whole squat workout, but basically my program was meant to be 220 3x3. Obviously that didn't happen, and you'll see that shortly. But my legs were cooked from those deficits. So this is 170. Not even moving very well, 170. Deficit work is very underrated for how much your legs work when doing it. And I haven't done deficit work in so long, so, you know, I was not ready for that. So I jumped straight from 70 to 220 because I thought, you know what, I'm tired. Let's just try and pump it out. And yeah, didn't move the best. So understood after that, I did not feel that good. I'm just gonna leave it there. So then I moved on to the hang power cleans here. To be fair, I did drop back actually to 190 and do a 3x3 back squat, which, you know, it is what it is. It's just practice at the end of the day. I'm sure next week I'll be doing 210s after, as my body acclimatizes to the program. So here's the hang power cleans. We built up to 130 3x3, pretty easy weight end of training. Again, we're just really emphasizing that power, which is the main focus of this block. So you'll be seeing in my vlogs a lot of power work. I do believe I can get the power up and my speed starts feeling better. It is going to transition really well into my Olympic lifts, as that is a very strong component of my Olympic lifting, is my speed. So, you know, practicing for power and speed is vitally important for myself as a lifter, as well as any lifter, to be fair. It's a very important aspect of Olympic weightlifting. So anyways, here's the triples at 130. They're feeling pretty good. Everything was moving well, ended the training session. So yeah, 130 is a nice weight just to sort of move a bit. I mean, it's not super heavy, but it's good just to practice and get, you know, that emphasis for technique and speed, feeling my feet move to the side, quick elbows, etc. So yeah, thanks for watching, guys. I hope you guys enjoyed the vlog. Make sure you like, comment, and subscribe, and we can keep these going. So thank you for watching and joining me on the journey. Let's get it. Let's get it, and let's keep moving forward. Cheers.